and welcome to part two of my Folklore Taylor Swift reaction. If you haven't seen part one, I'm going to leave a link up here and in the description box down below. But otherwise, welcome back. And I'm very excited. I've had a little cup of tea and had a little change and I'm feeling refreshed and I've soaked in the first eight tracks. Now I'm going to soak in the next eight and just see what Taylor is offering. August really felt like a finale in a way, so it's going to be cool to see what Hoax, the other bookend, as Taylor had described, of this whole album is going to be like. But first we've got to listen to This Is Me Trying. Here we go. There's a heavy delay on that snare, isn't there? Quite a rough sounding synth as well. If you listen to this intro and no one told you it was a Taylor Swift song, would you automatically think that's a Taylor Swift song? No, you would not. But who knows anymore? Ooh. There's that bass, but it's changing in a way that doesn't necessarily follow the chord sequence you think it would, which is cool. And lyrically, she's saying she's had a hard time thinking about this person leaving or the breakup? What is going on? Baby, I don't find no one to say. Weird chords, aren't they? When you go, I just wanted you to know that this is me trying. Ha! That's cool because you almost think she's going to go, this is me trying, but she does the opposite. She goes up, catches your attention, catches you off guard slightly, melody-wise. I just wanted you to know that this is me trying. How are those chords? It's like an orchestra warm-up. You know the orchestra warm-up sound? That's me trying to do all of the instruments. But it is. If you don't know what I'm talking about, go and YouTube orchestra warming up and have a listen. And then come back and listen to this song and see if you agree with me. I find that lyric interesting because she said she got wasted like all her potential. Now, she can't be talking about potential career-wise because, you know, but in terms of relationships, that really interests me. What is that about? And the way that chorus comes in, again, very smooth, creeps up on you. You don't know what's happening until you're into the first phrase. Yeah, and her vocal is just heavily layered. Again, another real continuity thing with this record where we're having layer, 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 tightly, compactly put together, and then a big reverb. So it sounds like one vocal. Listen to this. That melody, da 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 da. Now that's the Taylor that I know. We're getting glimpses of her older stuff in this new stuff. Wow, I like that. Almost going there, not quite. Another track ending with the drums. Wow. Okay. And the next one's called Illicit Affairs. Now, unless I'm otherwise mistaken, I'm assuming that this is her writing again about another situation that's not affected her. But I mean, I don't know. I don't know. And I may not know until I listen or even afterwards. Okay, so we're back to our acoustic guitar. Nobody sees you leave. The first thing that I notice is in that guitar, you still get the, even though it's kind of shuffling along, you still get the picked out melody. But that first lyric makes sure nobody sees you leave. Okay, so is she telling it from the perspective of she's having an affair? Hood over your head, keep your eyes down. okay, I'm sorry to stop again, but keep your eyes down and she's gone up. Now, songwriters cleverly will utilize words like up and down and usually follow what the word is saying. So, or you might have a song where it goes, and then I just stop, and you have a little break in the music, things like that. But she's done the opposite. Clever Taylor. Tell yourself you can always stop what started. Isn't that funny that I said about stop and then she had the lyric with stop? She didn't stop, but I still think it's funny. I'm psychic. That's the thing about illicit affairs. Her vocals come forward. Meetings and it dies a million little times. Oh, do you hear that? That is clever because she's just had this lyric saying it dies a million different times. And it's almost like those are all the little pieces. And listen to all the fluttering. That's the thing about illicit affairs. And now you can really hear the layers of vocals. Meetings and stolen stairs. You want to sweep? Don't call me kid. Don't call me baby. Anyone else? The backing vocals are almost Disney-esque in the whoo. You know, the shimmery shininess of them, even amongst this darker track. Ruin myself. I feel like you could get dueling guitars with this. Wow. Okay, so I'm still not 100% convinced. I'm just taking off my socks, by the way. Not 100% convinced that I know exactly the perspective of this particular song, or even some of the rest of them. And I know that everyone has their ideas, but until I hear it from Taylor herself, which I may never, then I may never know. We're into our acoustic guitar section, aren't we? Green was the colour of the grass where I used to read at Centennial Park. I used to think I'll meet somebody there. I feel like Taylor's vocal, she's really trying to use it in a different way. She really is. She's thought about what she's done before. And now she's thinking, well, what different timbres, what different tones can I find within my voice? And she's putting that forward as a big stamp, big old stamp on this record. Again, the drums are doing this shuffly, just like the guitar is. Everything's following itself. Okay, that's very clever. I thought invisible string was going to be something about guitar, but no, I don't know why I even thought that, because of course it's going to be about fate. There's a kind of grit in this song. Invisible string. I like how we had the green grass at the beginning and now she's giving us a few more colours. She's painting the picture, literally. Ooh, chord changes here. Yeah. Makes me want to sing, so I sung. Okay, Mad Woman. Back to our piano. But we still got that. Oh, so her darker vocal and her kind of vengeance in her lyrics here match. Everything matches together really nicely. But then you have the piano on the top giving a little lightness. What do you sing on your drive home? What does she mouth? You forever. Oh, Taylor. Every time you call me crazy, again more crazy. What about that? What a shame she went back. Yeah. Yeah. This my song. This is such a clever song lyrically, and it's broaching a subject that I think is very difficult to broach, actually. I don't know, you have that interaction where it just makes you more angry and more angry, and there isn't a reasonable solution to it in a way. And you pull that bear till the claws come out. Move on, but you know I won't. There's an electric guitar in the background now, really pretty addition. She's too. Listen to all the layers. It's almost tribal.
Yeah.
Great song. Great song, start to finish. Loved it. Loved it, Taylor. I've got goosebumps so many times during this record. Wow, I feel like I'm on a sinking ship. There's darkness in this because so many notes are blended together.
Keep your helmet, he's your rival.
There was a bit of distortion on the end of that. Which is cool. I don't know if that was on purpose or if it happened by accident and they left it in. But I liked it. I noticed it. I liked it. This is a very interesting track. This makes me think, you know, Taylor is kind of exploring different parts of music that she's bringing that kind of music to the forefront. She's giving artists who do this kind of music an opportunity to come through as well. I'm really pleased that she's just kind of thrown caution to the wind and just put out this record that is so different and opens doors. It opens doors, this record. Listen to those harmonies. Okay, so I'm just gonna have a look at the lyrics of this song because I feel like this is one of the most poignant ones lyrically. Doc, I think she's crashing out in some things you just can't speak about. Only 20 minutes to sleep, but you dream of some epiphany, just one single glimpse of relief to make some sense of what you've seen. Wow. Wow. You know, there's so many ways you could interpret this, but there's no getting around the direct feel of the song. No matter which way you try and play it, of where the story comes from, it just hits you, doesn't it, in a certain way.
Hold your hand to plastic now.
Notice how we're just getting these big strikes, dun, and then the it's like a ticking clock in the background. You can't change what's coming. Oh, beautiful. I'm done. This song is like a song by Enya, and Enya is one of my favorite artists, so I can't even tell you. Is Taylor a fan of Enya? I don't know this. I feel like she is.
But you dream of
She's giving us a moment to soak in everything at the end of this song. Just letting it fade out for us. Very thought-provoking song. And the next up is Betty, which I know everyone's kind of saying, ah, it's the name of Ryan Reynolds and Blake Lively's child, and who knows if it is or isn't, but we're gonna listen to the song, see what we think. Oh, Monica.
Betty, I won't make assumptions about why you switched your homeroom, but I think it's cause of me. You heard the rumors from Inez, you can't believe a word she says.
It's like all the children are speaking to each other.
Thing that, but if I just showed up at your party in the garden, trust me.
Okay, so this makes me think that Taylor's playing the role of someone else talking to this Betty character and going through the motions of the beginning of a relationship.
Know that, plus I saw you dance with him.
The guitar really moving on here.
I was walking home. Stones
descended.
I love you when she pulled up.
We got the double track vocal, but just those little stop gaps in the music was cool.
James, get in, let's try, boys, turned in.
James Taylor. So the piano just adds in another layer. And then we get this key change.
Cardigan.
I like that movement. Dun. That's an interesting song, isn't it? That is one to decipher, for sure. Does it look like I'm making the sound? Oh, harmonize those guitars, why don't you?
A coming of age is come and gone. Suddenly the summer rains is just around the corner, darling, cause it lives in me.
She said, darling. Now it's a Taylor Swift album.
I'm a fire and I'll keep your brittle heart warm, but you got a friend in me.
That's where Taylor's vocal flips, but you got a friend in me. So you get the different colour within her vocal very quickly.
Family that it shows, now that I see your brother as my brother.
I see your brother as my brother. Oh, I love that lyric. Oh, emotional. Yeah. Yeah.
Is it enough? Robbers to the east, clowns to the west.
Dun, 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 dun. That melody reminds me of something.
Would it be enough if I could never give you peace?
Oh, that got to me. Wow. Yeah, that got to me. I relate to that song a lot, and she sure knows how to get into my brain. And Taylor feels like your friend because she says the things that happen to you that you're afraid to say yourself. Okay, Hoax, don't make me cry, please.
My only one, this has broken me down.
Ah, so when we were talking earlier about having the word and then following that in the melody, there she did that. So down, down.
Stood on the cliffside screaming, give me a reason.
The whole of this album, and here is a great example of this, Taylor has chosen to illuminate a lot of the phrases with harmonies and vocal layers the whole way through a chorus or the whole way through a verse, instead of picking out things. And I often talk about that in my reviews and my reactions, just talking about how it's good to sort of pick out certain phrases. But actually what Taylor's shown me through this record is that you can pick out the whole thing, and if you arrange it in the right way, it is magical.
This love's the only hoax I believe in. You know I left a part
just comes
in
and grabs
New York. Still hurts underneath my scars from when they pulled me apart.
I feel like Taylor's almost very cleverly, obviously we had the whole snake thing, and I feel like she's shedding that skin in this song and becoming a new person.
But what you did was just as dark.
Wow.
Oh. And this was just as hard. Don't want no other shade of blue but you.
And that's an interesting lyric, don't want no other shade of blue but you, because the blue is the darker side of everyone, or the sadder parts. So that she's saying that in this song, she still wants those dark bits.
No other sadness in the world would do.
What a way to end that record. I just don't even know what to say. I do feel like it was the right thing to do though, to split it into two. It feels like an album of two halves, and that this story is being told, but we just come through some wall at some point, and that's especially obvious in Hoax, where, as I say, it feels like a new person has emerged. What do you think of the second half of Folklore? What do you think of the first half? What's your favorite song altogether from this record? Don't make me choose. You know I don't like choosing. Maybe Exile. But maybe Peace. I don't know. There's something special about all of them, and I feel like it's one of those records I need to sit back and let soak in and listen to it in different ways. Sit by a window and watch passings by and listen to it. Drive in my car and listen to it. Lie in my bed and listen to it. You know, it's that kind of record that you need to soak in a lot of different ways and just let settle in you. So I'm gonna go and do that. And in the meantime, please let me know what your favorite songs are and why you love or hate or whatever this album, and what you think it means and what it means to you in the comments box down below. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, please do hit that subscribe button, turn on the notifications, become part of our family here. And you can of course find me on Twitter and Instagram at Nina_Schofield. And you can find links to my new music, music and to my Wisio page where I can help you with your singing, alongside a link to my Spotify playlist Healing Hits in the description box down below. And I will see you very, very soon. Love you. Take care. Stay safe. Bye. Love you, Taylor.